I'm born a Muslim. Well, I'm a Muslim. That's how you're tagged in society. It's given to you by birth. So I decided to write a story that would reflect the community I live in. That's what this story is about. It's about, not just about the community, it's also about the link between how communities can be different, but human beings feel the same, our requirements are the same, although we come from different cultures. That's what made me write this play. And it revolves around marriage. It's a romantic comedy. It does discuss very 21st century issues, such as child marriage, such as feminism, such as nationalism, and also the English language and its use in a post-colonial island, Sri Lanka, Ceylon.
No guessing what's on everyone's mind. And then you have that uncle who thinks he's really cool, gives you a wink and thumbs up like I needed it.
Maybe he thought you'll never get married.
I think it brings together the differences and also the similarities of two cultural groups. It's interesting for us to see how, see as a Sinhalese, the traditions of a Muslim marriage and the their culture, and to see how similar they really are. And basically, it's all the same, the gossip, the humor, and the jokes, all of them are the same. So it was really interesting to find that out. Well, this is a very interesting play, and it's funny, but it also has its, moments, emotional moments. So I think whoever sees it will understand what, especially a young girl would, go through when it comes to marriage and the things that she thinks about and her thought processes.
My child, you're always last moment case. I asked you to get the flowers set up and the curtains straight and ready in the morning. And what is that sound outside by the window?
Yes, madam, but then again you wanted to bring your sari from dry cleaners, polish the floor, make 300 cups of coffee for Kopi Kudu and arrange the cutlery.
Yes, yes. You got all of that done and forgot what was most important. What is this sound?
Parisamin. Oi janedin vidin res. Adaratriya palu sandar.
We had a screening of this drama before this one. It was in Kandy, and actually both of us were not acting in that drama. It was the girl who was playing Rukaya was one of my friends, and she contacted me because she won't be able to take part in the drama this time. So she asked me if I would like to play the character, and I said yes.
No one touched me! Don't you dare touch me!
What? What do you mean? Are you serious?
Just don't touch me. I don't want to be touched by you.
Why? To be intimate is an intrinsic part of marriage. Come, let me lay you bare.
Yuck!
What on God's good earth is wrong with you? We are married.
Being a non-Muslim and being in the shoes of a Muslim is quite interesting. And it's a great experience, I must say.
Relationships I should know about before we get along as a couple.
Great. We seem to be making progress. We're finally a couple now. Honestly, yes. The girl that made the first coming, we were sort of going out for her.
What? Did you have sex?
Now that is very upfront.
Answer the question.
That is personal.
No. Now tell me, did you or did you not?
I've been into theatre since I was in school, since I was about 14 years old, and I've acted in a lot of stage plays in school as well, and also at university. And it was after university that I joined Sri Theatre Company, so I've been doing it for a really long time now.
My parents forced me into marriage to a doctor. It did not last long. We were not compatible for each other. Or tasteful for each other.
We've actually been friends for like really good friends for quite a long time. So I believed it to be a...
It was very awkward, to say the least, to play husband and wife.
Yeah, but it was a good icebreaker.
Yeah.
By the end of the day. And,
I think we were already pretty comfortable with each other, but it was difficult to get into the mindset that Chanaka was playing my husband.
Mithma was playing my wife.
You're crazy, you make me sound like a rapist.
I am warning you.
You know what? I can rape you. Who are you going to complain? What are you going to do?
I will scream and make everyone walk in. That way your reputation will forever be blemished.
The first drama we stage is 21st Century Monk. That was 5 years ago. And then we staged another play called It's All Amidst. And then the year after, we staged a play called Anarchy, which we took down to Gaul. And now it's this play, To Be or Not To Be.
Quite different. You get to be in the shoes of someone else, and maybe sometimes it will be a fictional character, most of the time. So that's quite intriguing.
What on earth do you think you're doing under the bed?
The stage is one of the few places where I feel the freest, because you can do whatever you want and no one is going to judge you for it, because you're actually being someone else. So yeah, you can be as crazy as you want, you can raise hell and no one really will really judge you for it. So it's one of the best places to be on.
Listen, but I don't know you. We met just last week, spoke to each other in front of our parents, and now we are here inside of a bedroom forced to...
The name of my character is Zina, and she's an elderly lady who is unmarried. She's still thinking about her past relationship with this guy, and who is at her niece's wedding. So that kind of sparks things up all over again and brings out old emotions.
So it can be done. Do you know why things happen in movies and dramas and people just go places?
Because it's fantasy?
No, it's because an initiative is made and acted upon.
I think what inspires most Sri Lankan English language dramatists to take this as a profession, I would say, is the inter-school Shakespeare drama competition. That's where it all starts. I think we all go through that process. And it's a very passionate competition, and that's where we see a lot of purpose to telling a story on stage. I've written 4 full-length productions, 1 short play. Yes.
Don't say that. That's rude.
Okay.
Your mom gets me married to her daughter, who is afraid of everything that marriage has to offer. And then her sister sneaks herself underneath the bed to observe all that we intend to do.
Well, I believe the inspirations that we had were our seniors at school.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Because I think both of our schools are pretty famous for the drama scene in Kandy, and we've really looked up to our seniors, and they were pretty amazing actors on both our parts. And we grew up watching all of these Zakis and Ayas perform, and they were our inspirations.
He's a nice young gentleman, better than the men 2 generations ago. How would you know? Experience, darling.
Well, my grandmother is actually she writes a little bit. Her name is Swemale Karunaratna, and she's written a couple of books, so she's been a big inspiration to me, I think.
You know this crazy person?
It's my auntie.
Oh, is that crazy one, is she?
That crazy one? What do you mean? It does not matter, darling. I guess me being on your bed confirms what I am.
What's wrong with your family? Your mommy is in a rush to get you married, and you don't want to get married. And then your auntie wants to spy on our first night.
I was born in Kandy. I studied at a private boys' school in Kandy, and I did drama in Kandy. That's where I made most of my friends. I still live there. And I studied cinema in India. And I realized cinema is very expensive, and the best way to tell stories, considering the current economy, for me, not for others, for me, would be on stage. And therefore, I opted to write theater. And that's what I've been doing so far. This is my profession, it's a job. So you've got to be consistent at writing theater and consistent at producing it. And hopefully, the younger generations, the generations to come, we'll be able to create a market for, especially in Kandy, for the younger generations to see this as a potential profession. At the moment, it's mostly a pastime activity, but I think we should try and evolve and make it as professional as possible.
I mean, working with Aslam, I think he's a really great actor. And as a director also, I think he has a lot of good advice to give us. And
Thank you.
And he directs you really well. And you can learn a lot from him. And I think it's been a really great experience.
I better get going now. This night should not revolve around me. So, you never spoke to him afterwards. Who? Mr. Veroz? We speak, but it's always very delicate. We tend to avoid certain topics that might resurface old feelings.
I was in my first actual stage drama was also directed by Aslam. And it was Midsummer Night's Dream, and we took part in the Shakespeare drama competition, and we won first place. Not to brag, but so that was pretty interesting, and that was my memorable performance.
Have you ever been with a prostitute?
No.
I read on Cosmopolitan magazine that if someone made a statement and followed it up by scratching their nose, then that person was lying. I am done with you. You are a pervert, and this affair is over. Talak.
Don't say words you might regret.
We can be as open as we want. That's one thing. And so he gives us space to be ourselves in the play, and to come up with new ideas, to give something new to the character that he has created, not what he has in mind, but to give something new from us, from within ourselves. So that's actually pretty good.
Yeah, he's a pretty chill guy, so so you can kind of put your own take onto the character and not be afraid that he would be offended or what not, because he's really okay with you making the character your own and putting your own opinion on, take on it. Yeah.
Take a seat here on the bench. Okay, go get some water.
I'm so sorry to have taken this time away from the two of you.
Well, considering how it was to end, you made it a lot more interesting.
So I hope everyone, whenever we perform in the future, sometime soon, hopefully, that all of you will come and be a part of our performance and enjoy.
You know, I've always admired your curves.
Uh-huh.
And I've been working out for quite a while now.
Uh-huh.
My. Your radiating skin draws me towards you.
No one hurts me!
So, when we do have another screening of To Be or Not To Be, we very warmly invite you all to come watch the show, because it is a very interesting family comedy that you can all enjoy.
It's me! Open the door!
Keep quiet, you lunatic! You think I'm some ordinary girl? Huh.
So you're a posh girl! I'm down, girl! She's been living in
a I'll go get the door! What rose petals?
Madam, it's you. I'm sorry, I have disturbed.
Nothing is happening tonight. Give me the flowers and good night.
Is everything all right, madam?
It's all fine. You can leave now, thank you. And please don't tell my aunt anything unnecessary.
Okay, madam.
To be or not to be, well, you'll be watching this video after the play, so you'll be missing it. For all those who missed this play, remember, you missed the greatest play ever, because you missed it. And next time we stage the play in Colombo or in Kandy, if you're in Kandy, Colombo, and we hope to take it down to Gaul in maybe 4 months' time, please do come and enjoy yourselves watching what we produced for you.